One of the most useful features of StoneCut Pro is the ability to take bitmap graphics and convert them into vector images. So at this point, what we have is a bitmap graphic, and if we go to CorelDRAW, we're just going to take a look at it in Corel, and we go into wireframe view, and we'll zoom in, you can see the pixels. So normally an image that's going to be a bitmap, you're going to see the actual pixels in the graphic as opposed to the vector lines. So one of the problems with images that are bitmaps is we can't send them to the vinyl cutter. It's very difficult to change the colors, and we can't convert it into a rhinestone pattern. So what we need to do is take this image and we need to convert it over to vector artwork so we can output it to the cutter, or even if we wanted to convert it to a rhinestone pattern. So we're going to go through the process of doing that in CorelDRAW so you can see a comparison of doing that process in CorelDRAW versus StoneCut Pro. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back over to View. I'm going to select Enhanced View in CorelDRAW, and the easiest way to trace this is just to right mouse click on it, go to the function Outline Trace, and then what we're going to do is we're going to pick a preset. So this is how you do it with Power Trace in CorelDRAW. I'm going to select the option for clip art for this particular image. Clip art is a pretty good setting. When you change the different presets in CorelDRAW, all that's really going on is the sliders here are moving based on different properties. So what we want to do is make sure that we're tracing inside the eyes and the teeth. We don't want to lose too much detail here. So once we get our settings dialed in, we'll go ahead and click on OK, and it's traced. And it's going to put the image right directly over the top of the original. Now here's the CorelDRAW image. We're going to leave that over there. And then what we're going to do is we're going to take this bitmap and we're going to drag and drop it over to StoneCut Pro. I could also go ahead and click on the toolbar icon here and transfer the image. Just want to make sure I select just the bitmap when I click on the little cut icon. Or I can drag and drop it. The way you can do that is just select it with your left mouse button, drag it onto the Windows taskbar. StoneCut Pro will pop up, and then just release it into your working document. There you go. So one of the things that I can do in StoneCut Pro, I can cheat a little bit. And what I mean by that is we have a very powerful function called posterization. If you take a really good close look at this graphic, you're going to see there's really no clear definition between the colors in the graphic. You can see the red and the black and the yellow, but there's little shades of yellow, little shades of red. And one of the things that we have to do before we convert it to a vector image through the process of tracing is we have to get rid of those little shades. It's very important that we do that because that's going to ensure we get the best quality. You know, when you're working with a bitmap graphic, you know, this graphic right here is about 250 dpi. It's pretty small. On the scale of good to bad, it's on the bad side of the scale, but we can still get a pretty good result here if we trace it. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to select the bitmap, and we're going to go to Image, and we're going to go to Posterize. And we're going to pick a setting of 2, and you can play around with these settings. What this is doing is it's getting rid of those dithering patterns, all those little dots, and making them solid colors. So the colors are going to change a little bit, but we can go back and recolor the image later. So it's very important that we pick the right setting. So we're going to pick a setting of 2. We'll click on OK. Now you can really see those jagged edges, but I'm not too worried about that because when we trace it, the software is going to be doing a pretty remarkable job of correcting that. So what we're going to do is we're going to zoom back out. We're going to go to Tools, and we're going to go to Vectorizing. We can also just click on V on our keyboard. So we want to make sure that object is selected. We'll click on Vectorizing, and the vectorizing window is going to pop up. Now let me kind of walk you through the different settings in the window. What you're going to see right here is the different colors in the graphic, and when we posterized it, some colors popped up that we didn't necessarily want. Now the software is very smart. It can ignore some of those smaller objects, but we can go and manually combine colors. And the way we do that is we can just click on the little color here, we can click on the next color, click on the next color, and then we can just reassign those. So these are the colors that we don't want, and we're going to click on those, and then we're going to map those to the red, and see we've reduced the colors. So now we have 4 colors. I can also get what we call a preview to see what the vectorization is going to look like. And you'll notice right here, the teeth are getting knocked out, so it's not actually picking up the small detail, because what it's doing is it's doing too much smoothing. So that's okay sometimes when you're working with logos, but when you're working with more abstract graphics, what you might want to do is have more accuracy as opposed to more smoothing. So you can move these sliders over here. We'll just move these sliders over to 3. And that's going to change everything. We're going to change the way it smooths curves, adjusts curves, how it's doing its node reduction, how it's working with contours. So normally if you're going to move a slider, move them all over. So we'll go ahead and click on preview. There we go, and see we got the little eyes and the teeth back. Now you have some other settings over here. You say create bitmap outline. That'll actually do a trace around every single pixel. We generally don't want that. Vectorize the background. If it's on a solid color background or it's on a white background, we can trace the background as well. A very important feature, optimize for text objects. What this is telling the software is, hey, there's something in there that's supposed to look like text. And we're going to use a different setting. We want to make sure that all the alignment on vertical objects is perfectly up and down, on horizontal objects is perfectly lined up. We want to smooth around curves so that it's going to look more like text when we trace it. And I normally leave that feature all the time. Avoid overlap, what that's going to do is it's going to make sure that lines don't sit on top of each other. So if we uncheck that, the lines are going to be adjacent to each other for the colors as opposed to sitting on top. And then allow contour size, that's a parameter for basically skipping over tiny little objects. So it's going to go ahead and skip over anything that's like a tiny little speck. But these settings you see right here are pretty good. We're just going to click on Optimize for Text Objects. We're going to limit the number of colors to no more than 16. So that's in your drop-down list right here. And we're going to click on OK. So there we go. Traced it pretty quick. So here's the original vector, and here's the bitmap. So let's do this. Let's take this vector, and let's drag and drop it back to CorelDRAW, and let's compare the two. So we're going to take the vector graphic right here, and we're going to drag it down here to the CorelDRAW. Icon's going to pop up on the desktop, and we're going to release it into the Corel workspace. Now let's take a look at the three graphics, and let's see what's going on with our graphics here. So here's the original. Let's zoom in on that. So here we go. That's what we started with right there. And you notice these sharp points right there. And let's take a look at the text. So not a great image. It's about 250 dpi, and it's pretty small. So let's see what Corel PowerTrace did in X5. So this is the X5 version. So you see that? It's a little bit lumpy over there. Let's see what's going on in the face. Not too bad. But let's see what's going on with the text. Wow, look at that. So that's pretty much a redo. Probably the easiest way to deal with that text would be to go in and redraw it. And this is one of the challenges, a lot of challenges using the PowerTrace function in Corel, but this is one of the biggest challenges. It just doesn't do a very good job on text and anything that has to look precise. So it works pretty good on abstract images, but it doesn't work very well on logos. So let's go ahead and take a look at the rest of this. Here's the image that was done with StoneCut Pro. You'll notice this is perfectly aligned, so that's a perfectly straight line. There's no lumps there. You'll also notice as we come down here to the dinosaur, did a great job in there. But let's take a look at the text here. Very little editing here. It's almost perfect. So the software does a phenomenal job. It lines everything up along the baseline. It smooths over these corner points, and there'd be very little editing that we'd have to do. Now, let me show you one last thing so you can get an idea of some of the differences. If we take this image right here and we're in CorelDRAW and we created this in StoneCut Pro, it's automatically going to build everything by color layer. So each one of these colors is going to be a separate layer. So we can go over here and ungroup it, and we can pull it apart, and you can see there's a layer for black, there's a layer for white, and there's a layer for red. It's going to be a little bit different in CorelDRAW. When we go ahead and ungroup this, what we're going to do is we're going to get all kinds of interesting little things going on. So you're going to get a part here, you're going to get a part here. Sometimes you can get little mystery parts. Let's go ahead and take a look at that in wireframe view. View, wireframe, let's zoom in, see what's going on in here. Yeah, so you get a little mystery area that's in here. Let's go ahead and take a look at the nodes in StoneCut Pro. And this is the image we did in StoneCut Pro. Completely different story. So you can see that the vectorization function is very powerful in StoneCut Pro. If you're using StoneCut Pro, there'd be no reason for you to use the vectorization or PowerTrace function in CorelDRAW, because I think what you'll find is StoneCut Pro does an infinitely better job. And that concludes this tutorial lesson.